Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel and welcome to my training on performance testing and engineering. So before I start this short demo session, so I would like to show my YouTube channel. So please like, share, subscribe to my channel, and here are our contact numbers and email IDs. All right, so this is my YouTube channel, so you can search for performance testing real-time training. And you see my channel with my phone number, right? So please like, share, subscribe to my channel. So we have some lots of interesting stuff getting uploaded to YouTube around performance testing and engineering concepts. Okay, so let me kickstart the demo session. So these are the performance testing basics that I'm going to cover initially for the first 10 to 15 hours. So, I'm going to start with SDLC, testing lifecycle, performance testing lifecycle, requirement gathering in detail, and performance test plan, and all this. All right. So we will see in the next demo sessions. All right. So these are I will be spending the first 10 to 15 hours for covering this performance testing basics. So before I start the session, actual demo session, so I would like to thank everyone who is part of my performance testing and engineering career, right? So my parents, my family, and I started my career with Applus Technology. So I would like to thank all my mentors, colleagues, and managers in Applus, right? And so here are a few people I would like to heartfully thank everyone. Fine. So, and all my previous batch trainees. So I started these online trainings in 2018. So I'd like to thank all my previous batch trainees and all my competitors who are giving healthy competition. Okay. So having said that, so, let me explain the agenda for this demo session. So these are the, agenda topics for today's demo session agenda. First, I would like to give a brief introduction about myself and unique features of my training plan and course duration, and what is performance testing and what are the different types of performance testing and who are the ideal participants. Okay. So, any of these, are suitable for this training. So BTEC or MCA or MSc computers or BCF freshers in active job search and manual test engineers and passionate BPO and non-IT employees who want to pursue career in performance testing. All right. So, I would like to discuss career prospects and compensation. Average packages in both product and service-based companies and digital platforms that we are leveraging for the training and course contents for beginner and advanced level participants. And scripting scenarios to cover in the training, all right, with both Loadrunner and JMeter. And demo script I will be covering in the next demo session, right? And I would like to discuss the, what placement assistance we are offering and what are the terms and conditions for, enrolling for this online training. Right, so this is a brief introduction about myself. So I'm an MCA graduate and having 14 plus years of experience in IT. And 12 plus years of experience in performance testing and engineering. So as I mentioned previously, I started my career with Applus Technologies. So Applus was the world's first largest independent software testing company. All right. So it was acquired by CSE and then acquired by DXC. So in Applus, while working for Applus, I worked on all major tools like Loadrunner, JMeter, Webload, SimPerformer. And I have experience till date in retail, healthcare, banking, and finance domains. Right. So my second organization was Tech Mahindra. So in Tech Mahindra, apart from the regular web and web services protocols, I got chance to work on multiple Loadrunner protocols as mentioned here, like Azure Show Client, Java VUser, Comdicom, Oracle NCA, Oracle 2-tier, and Web Apps Leveling. Right, so I have around experience on around 10 protocols with Loadrunner, and Bank of America is my third organization. So you know, like I got exposure to banking domain and experience in all these tools like JMeter, Jenkins, Splunk, Introscope, Dynatrace, WebLogic Console, OEM, AppWatch, and you know, apart from load and soak test, I got chance to work on capacity planning tests as well, right? And I'm a certified associate in JMeter, so which I have done recently, and I'm also certified associate in Splunk and Dynatrace, you know, which I have done when I was working with Bank of America. And I'm currently working for a reputed ERP product-based organization as a principal performance engineer. So, and these are the salient features of my training, right? The first thing is like, I'm offering earn while you learn, right? So I will explain like, you know, what is the program going forward. So these are the salient features of my unique features of my training plan. And this would be the roadmap for any batch, whether it is a daily batch or a weekend batch. So the first 10 minutes, I will be covering daily aptitude test. So for the, you know, this is to, this is to engage everyone who is attending our training sessions, as well as accommodate the late joiners. So in the first 10 minutes, like I would be, you know, like covering aptitude questions, both verbal and nonverbal. So, you know, like nowadays, like a few companies are, you know, in the recruitment process, like, you know, like they are evaluate in the process of evaluation, like they are giving, you know, asking the candidate to attend an evaluation. So, you know, like in the first round. So basically they use few organizations are using this aptitude test, you know, to filter the candidates, right? So I would like to cover like, I would spend like first 10 minutes for, you know, aptitude test, both verbal and non-verbal. So the next 10 minutes I will be spending on daily assessment. So I mean to say like, you know, we will be having some assessment on the previous day concepts for the first 10 minutes. And the next 50 to 60 minutes I will be spending on theory or scripting sessions. So this is the breakup for 1.5 hour session, daily, you know, if it is daily batch. So, right. So weekend session would be for 3 hours. Right. So I'll be, you know, spending like 2 hours, you know, on this theory or scripting sessions if it is a weekend batch or a weekend session. So the next 10 minutes, the last 10 minutes, like I would be spending for Q&A session and doubts clarification. Right. So this would be the breakup for, you know, for a daily session. Right. And I have made the scripting simplified and easy to understand. So the first and foremost query that I receive from the participant, from the inquiries is like, you know, like how much of programming skills or how much of scripting skills are required, right? So, you know, in performance testing, we use Lodamer and JMeter, which are record and playback tools. And we need not write any code from scratch, right? But we will be, you know, like we will be using tools like Lodamer or JMeter to record the script. And we do enhance the script. And yes, it requires some basic programming like if loops and for loops. Right. If someone is good in programming, that would be an added advantage, right? So it would be, you know, cakewalk for, you know, like those who are having coding skills, right? But if someone is not having very good programming skills also, you know, like as we use most of the tools which are record and playback, right? And, you know, like I have simplified the scripting and made it easy to understand. All right. So, and I picked most of the scripts of different companies interviews, like which are given in scripting mostly. And, you know, like covering all the scripting challenges, you know, including web custom request. Right. And another, you know, unique feature of my training is like scripting hands-on mandatory for every participant. So every participant has to work on the script and, you know, share the script to me. A review. So I will be like reviewing the script and verify, you know, like the scripting standards or, you know, naming conventions and, you know, like whether the script is achieving the desired functionality as expected or not. So I'll be reviewing everyone's script. Okay. So scripting is mandatory for every participant and we are, you know, so we are targeting Lodamer and JMeter certification. You know, out of which Lodamer is optional and JMeter is mandatory. So the reason is like Lodamer, you know, certification, if you want to attempt a certification, like it involves a exam fees of around 15K INR. So, but whereas, you know, JMeter certification we can do free of cost. So JMeter certification is mandatory for everyone. And I would be covering three protocols, web, web services, and TrueClient in LoadRunner, right? And I would be giving hands-on training on scripting with real-time examples and 15 plus scripts given in, scripting test of various companies' interviews, right? So, for these scripting exercises, I would be using 5 sample applications and 4 real-time applications, both for scripting and test executions, right? And here are few more, unique features of my training. So, for every day, we would be spending, we'd be taking up some topic, some current affairs, or some technical topic as, for tabletop discussion, right? So every participant has to speak for a minute every day. So this is to improve the soft skills, and make them speak basically, right? So few candidates, though they are good in technical, they may not be, few will not be having good communication skills, right? So this is the, reason why we are taking these table topics, right? And presentations by participants, that is something which we do it on once in a month. The course duration would be 3 months. So, every participant has to give a presentation on some performance testing or engineering topic. So this is basically to enhance their soft skills, right? And we are leveraging digital platforms for training, assessments, and assignments. I will be using Google Classroom for giving assignments, and I have designed some online assessment with multiple choice questions picked from various companies, online assessments, right? So I would be doing weekly and monthly assessments as well, right? And we do have scripting competition. So we started doing it from the last batch. So, I will be giving one script randomly and, with some gift prize of, prize amount of 500 for LoadRunner and 500 for JMeter script, right? So once the training is completed, I will be helping in resume preparation, right? Or, after post which, I will be taking up five mock interviews after the training. So the first mock interview would be by myself, right? So, and there would be 4 mock interviews by third party, 2 mock interviews by guys working in service-based companies, and I would schedule 2 mock interviews by guys working for product-based companies. So this is to basically, I would also be there in the mock interviews, whenever we are scheduling third party mock interviews. So this is to assess, the training strengths and areas of improvement, and also to not miss any real interview opportunity. All right. So these are the unique features of my training plan. And last but not the least, earn while you learn, right? So I have, please contact me on the given mobile number. So to know more about this program, right? So I make sure that, the trainees earn the amount which they are spending for the time, right? So these are the unique features of my training plan. Please like, share, subscribe to my channel. And here are my contact numbers and email ID for any further inquiries, right? So, and finally, I would like to explain performance testing course contents for beginner and advanced. Right. So first of all, let me start with course contents for beginners. So I'd be spending 10 to 15 hours on performance testing basics, like SDLC, testing lifecycle, right? Starting from SDLC, testing lifecycle, performance testing lifecycle, and what is a HTTP request? HTTP basics, right? And Fiddler, developer tools, and so on, right? So I would be spending 10 to 15 hours on the performance testing basics. So once we are done with the basics, I would be starting LoadRunner Professional 2020. This is the latest version. So I will be covering scripting with 3 protocols, as I mentioned previously, web services, and TrueClient protocols. And JMeter, I will be covering with, the latest version 5.3, right? And once we are done with these tools, these are the major tools in the market nowadays. So once we are done with these two, both these tools, like I will be covering monitoring with open source tools and analysis, and developer tools, Fiddler. Yes, I'll be covering them extensively, like how, you know, how we use developer tools or Fiddler in a day-to-day life, and you know, like basic SQL queries and SQL tools like Toad and Git and GitHub, right? So these would be the course contents for beginners. All right. So, and let me explain like advanced concepts, which I am going to cover for work, you know, performance testing units who are already into performance testing career. Right. So the first one, you know, in advanced concept is like, you know, JMeter integration with InflexDB, Grafana and ELK Stack, right? And Loadrunner Enterprise, which is formerly called as Performance Center, and Loadrunner Cloud, and Java JC concepts, Unix, Linux, Git, GitHub, CI/CD with Jenkins, right? Continuous integration and continuous development and deployment with Jenkins, and Docker, Kubernetes, microservices, and all container concepts, monitoring and analysis, and Splunk with dashboard queries. So I will make you, you know, build some dashboards using Splunk queries, and I will be covering Dynatrace out of this. So if anyone opt for AppD, like, yes, we, you know, like we have a separate trainer for AppD. So, you know, like I would be covering Dynatrace out of this, and AWR report analysis, thread dump and heap dump analysis, and performance engineering with some real-time use cases. So these are the concepts that, you know, like I'm going to cover for performance testing units, right? And the course duration for, you know, like these freshers or beginners would be 80 to 100 hours, right? Yes, it would be 80 to 100 hours for a, you know, over a duration of 2 to 3 months. And advanced concepts would be 40 to 50 hours, right? So I maintain a tracker for each batch. I'll show you like, you know, the tracker for the previous batches so that you can understand, like, you know, these numbers are something which are real time numbers, like, you know, which are collected from the previous batches, right? So, and let me explain what is performance testing at a very high level, right? So let me give some example over here, right? So say, for example, you have IRCTC web application. So you know how many users they, you know, on an average use IRCTC application? Yeah, so on a normal day, right, on an average, IRCTC application, you know, number of tickets, first of all, number of tickets booked on IRCTC will be 18 to 20 lakhs as per the recent statistics, right? Of course, before this COVID, right? So, so like, you know, 18 to 20 lakh tickets will be booked on IRCTC application. Out of these, 15 to 16 lakhs will be booked, tickets will be booked online. The rest of the tickets will be booked at IRCTC reservation counters, right? So around 15 lakh tickets will be booked per day pan India, right, on IRCTC application, right? And the number of users who would be using IRCTC application would be around 5 to 8 lakhs. Yes, you heard it right. So 5 to 8 lakh users use IRCTC application on an average, right? Now, so if IRCTC has introduced some new feature, say for example, you know, IRCTC recently introduced a feature called, you know, confirmation probability, right? So some new feature is being introduced by IRCTC, right? So before introducing that new feature into production, so they have to test that application, test that new feature, or test IRCTC application with that new feature in test environment. So basically they have to do load test, soak test, right, before pushing that code with that new feature into production, right? So they do this by simulating real world business flows of the application. Say for example, booking a ticket or canceling a ticket, right? So, you know, like our registration, user registration, right, booking a hotel room and so on, all right? So performance testing or load testing, so is something which we simulate real business flows of your application and test the application with expected user load and more than expected user load, right? And we test the application under predefined concurrency, and we validate the application or server's readiness ahead of peak events. Say, for example, like if it is an e-commerce application like Flipkart or Amazon, you know, like everyone knows Big Billion Sale or Black Friday Sale, right? So if you want to validate the application or server's readiness ahead of such peak events, so we do performance testing for those applications, right? And we test the application stability and before and after the version release, right? So this is performance testing at a very high level. So I will be explaining performance testing and you know what are the factors that drive performance testing in the next session, right? So I'll be starting with SDLC. As I mentioned previously, I'll be explaining testing lifecycle, right? So I'll be explaining all these in detail in my training sessions, right? And this is performance testing all about. So it is non-functional testing to determine an application's speed, stability, scalability, and reliability, right? So it's non-functional testing to determine an application's speed. When I say speed, it is a response time of each page. And the stability refers to like how stable is the application under expected load and more than expected load, right? And coming to scalability, how scalable is the application? And coming to reliability is like, you know, how reliable is the application once it is in production, right? So I explained this in detail in the next slide, right? So about this, what do we exactly check in speed, you know, stability, scalability, and reliability, right? And while testing the application, while we do performance testing of the application, so we do monitor these performance metrics both on the client side and server side. So the important client side metrics are response time of each page, hits per second, and throughput. Whereas like coming to server side metrics, these are the important server side metrics that we monitor on each of the server, right? On each layer or on each tier, like web tier or application server tier and DB tier. So we do monitor like percent processor time, available memory on the servers, percent disk utilization, percent disk time, and you know, network utilization, right? And processor queue length. So these are the important, very few important metrics that we monitor when we are doing performance testing, right? And you know, let me explain like, you know, what are the factors or what are the reasons for doing performance testing for an already existing application and for a newly built application. So before starting this, please like, share, subscribe to my YouTube channel. So now let me explain like what are the factors, you know, which drive performance testing for an already existing application and, you know, for a newly built application, right? So the first and foremost thing is, you know, like implementing a new module or new functionality. So let me take some example over here, right? So I just now quoted one example of IRCTC. So IRCTC introduced a new feature recently called confirmation probability. So once we, you know, like while booking the ticket, user can check the confirmation probability. How, you know, how probable, what is the probability percentage of that waitlisted ticket getting confirmed, right? So when, and in the same way, Redbus has introduced a new feature last year, right? Called rescheduling the ticket. So, you know, instead of canceling the ticket and booking it again, so Redbus has introduced a new feature called rescheduling the ticket, right? So whenever some such new functionality is introduced into any application, right? So even though the application is already in production, we have to do performance testing. I mean, like Redbus or IRCTC or Flipkart or Amazon. So they have to do performance testing for their application, even though it is already in production, right? And let me coming to the next example. Increasing number of users or adding new users, right? Right. So, you know, increasing number of users or adding new users. So let me give an example for this. Right. So everyone might have heard this, you know this, you know, Kotak Mahindra Bank recently acquired ING Vysya Bank, right? So I think in a couple of 1 or 2 years back, Kotak Mahindra Bank acquired ING Vysya Bank, right? Now assume that, you know, like Kotak Mahindra Bank has some 10 lakh users, right, across the globe. And now ING Vysya Bank has some 5 lakh users for their net banking application. So post merger, right? Post merger of ING Vysya Bank with Kotak Mahindra, obviously all the users will be like all the previous users of ING Vysya Bank would be using the new Kotak Mahindra Bank application, right? So there is an increase in the number of users here, right? Or there are new users getting added to the application, right? So in such cases, like Kotak Mahindra Bank has to test the, you know, do performance testing for their already existing application to find out whether, you know, like the already existing infrastructure can support these new users or not, right? So this is the second example that I can give. And the third point is like a major software upgrade, like database or OS migration, right? So, you know, like whenever, you know, there is a database upgrade, right? Or whenever there is some OS migration, yes, we have to do performance testing, even though the application is already in production. And whenever there is an hardware upgrade also, we have to do performance testing, right? So these are the four major cases where we have, why we have to do performance testing for an already existing system, right? And coming to newly built application, right? So these are the, you know, driving factors for doing performance testing for a newly built application. The first and foremost thing is assess the readiness of production environment and determine the capacity of existing system, right? So to assess like how ready is the application to go into production and to determine the capacity of existing system as well, right? And creating benchmark for future systems, right? So I'll be covering like, you know, what is benchmark and baseline in the training session. So this is another objective for doing performance testing for a newly built application, comparing multiple platforms and create performance characteristics with different system configurations, right? And validating any application against this performance criteria. So let me give one example here. I work when I was working for Bank of America, so the performance criteria of our application is like to achieve some 12,000 transactions per hour, right? And you know, with around 1,000 users, right? So we need to validate the application against this performance criteria as such for a newly built up, I mean, like, you know, for any application. And the next important, you know, driving factor for doing performance testing is uncover what components of an application suffer poor performance and under what conditions and load exactly, right? And to find out any performance bottlenecks, right? And to support the system tuning, right? So these are the couple of, you know, factors which drive performance testing, or these are the goals of doing performance testing for an already existing application and for a newly built application, right? So these are the prerequisites for performance testing. I'll be discussing in detail, you know, in the next session, in the next demo session. And these are the different types of performance testing, right? So the first and foremost is load testing, right? So load testing is something which we do with expected or normal user load for 1 to 2 hours, right? And the next type of testing is stress testing. So stress testing is something that we do with more than normal load on the application. Say, for example, you have IRCTC or Redbus, you know, like travel applications, right? So, and you know, like during festival days or vacation, like we will be generally mostly having more than expected load on the application, right? So to simulate such scenarios and to test such kind of scenarios, we do something called stress testing, right? The next type of testing is soak or endurance test. So I have detailed explanation of each of these tests in the next slide, right? So the next type of testing is soak or endurance test, right? So these are long duration tests, you know, like for a duration of, you know, depending on the business hours of the application, right? And the next type of testing is spike testing. The best example I can give for spike testing is, you know, Tatkal booking for IRCTC or flash sale or big billion sale or Flipkart or Amazon, right? So, you know, like we know, like during Tatkal booking, the window will be, you know, that kids will be available for just 5 to 10 minutes. So eventually, like there will be a big spike in the user load, or there will be a sudden surge in the user load when Tatkal booking opens, right? In the same way, you know, like whenever we have flash sale or big billion sale kind of events on e-commerce applications, like, you know, Flipkart or Amazon. So we do have, you know, a sudden surge in the user load So when we are testing such kind of applications, like we have to do this pipe testing, right? The next type of testing is volume testing and scalability testing, right? And you know, like there are a few other performance testing types like failure testing and you know capacity testing. So which I will be covering in detail in the sessions, training sessions, right? So you know, like this slide consists of you know a few more data points for load testing, soak testing, spike testing, and stress testing, right? So here you can see load testing simulates in when we are doing load test, we simulate current user load on the system. That is current user load or normal user load on the system. And you know, load testing will be usually done for 1 to 2 hours. And you know, this test ensures that application is stable and can handle at the expected peak load, right? And load testing is mandatory test that will be done prior to any other performance test type, right? So once we are done with the load test, we do something called soak or endurance test. So basically this is conducted for longer durations based on the business hours of the application, right? And the main objective is to identify performance bottlenecks like memory leaks and connection leaks, etc. So we'll be discussing what is a memory leak, what are connection leaks in the sessions, right? And the next type of testing is stress test. So which I have explained, you know, like in the previous slide. So, you know, like stress testing is done by gradual increasing the user load till the application breaks, right? So main testing or main purpose of stress testing is to identify an application's breakpoint. And, you know, like the response times are obviously like, you know, the moment where like response times increases and error count increases, right? So is termed as a breakpoint, or you know the application stops responding, right? So you know like a couple of other types of testing, important types of testing are spike test, volume test, and scalability testing, right? So these are the different performance testing types, right? So you know like so now let me quickly you know like show you like how the assessment is going to be. So, you know, like for each session, we will be having a, you know, assessment on the next day, right? Or on the same day, if it is a weekend session. So this is how, you know, like the daily assessments are going to be, right? So, you know, like, so what type of test is this, right? So on the x-axis, I have duration, test duration. On y-axis, we have virtual users, right? So there will be, you know, daily assessments like this, right? So I'm showing you a couple of graphs representing each load test, and I will be taking some quick assessment on a daily basis, right? So this is how you know like the daily assessment is going to be, right? So with this I stop this demo session and this introduction to performance testing, right? So in the next session, okay, so going back to the agenda, let me quickly cover the, you know, what are the other, you know, agenda topics. So I explained, I gave my introduction, unique features of my training plan and the performance testing and types of performance testing. And I explained here, like, who are the ideal participants, right? And coming to career prospects and compensation, right? So performance testers, test engineers, right? So they are more or less equally paid with developers, right? That is the first point I would like to make. And you know, like if you consider the average salary, number of years into 2 lakhs is the you know average salary that we can expect in a service-based organization, right? So if someone is having 3 years of experience, like you know, the average salary that they can expect is like around 6 lakhs in a service-based company. And if they are going to, you know, they're working for a product-based company, it can be up to number of years into 3 lakhs. That is, for 3 years experience, like, you know, 8 to 9 lakhs is the average salary in a product-based company, right? So as far as I know, right? And, you know, like, this is in, you know, like, cities like Hyderabad, right? So if you consider, you know, costly cities like where cost of living is high, cities like Bangalore or Mumbai or Pune, so it would be more than that. And I know people like who are drawing a number of years into 4 lakhs package in product-based companies. So in fact, one of my trainee got, you know, 11.3 lakhs package for Morgan Stanley. So that is the highest that my trainees got for 3 years experience. 11.3 lakhs is the package that one of my weekend batch trainee got, right? And you know, like that is in for Pune location. And for Hyderabad, like, you know, for 4 years, like 11 lakhs is the package that my trainee got till date, right? That is the highest package that my trainees got till date. And while average package remains like number of years into 2 lakhs in service-based companies and number of years into 3 lakhs in a product-based company in Hyderabad, right? And I explained, like, you know, digital platforms that we are leveraging for training, like Google Classroom, where I will be giving assignment for each batch, right? And you have to, you know, like, trainees have to share the script to me, right? So we are using GitHub to upload the script, right? To right for review. And, you know, I already explained the course contents for beginners and advanced participants. And these are the scripting scenarios. So let me show you the scripting scenarios that I'm going to cover, right? So, you know, like these are the scripting scenarios that I will be going to cover in the scripting sessions with sample applications initially. So once we are, you know, once everyone is comfortable with scripting on the sample applications, like, you know, I will be providing 4 live applications, right? So total, you know, 8 to 9 applications we would be using for scripting. All right. So demo script I will be covering in the next session, that next demo session. So with Loadrunner and JMeter. And once the training is completed, so as I explained previously, like, you know, I will be helping on the resume preparation, right? And, you know, I'd be providing referrals as well. So, you know, 50% of the recruitment goes through referrals. So I'd be providing, you know, sources of getting those referrals as well. And coming to the last and but not the least, the terms and conditions. As I mentioned previously, so everyone has to do scripting. Hands-on is mandatory for every participant, right? So that is the first and foremost condition, right? And the training duration would be 80 to 100 hours. Right. So, you know, no fast track batch. Right. So you have to, you know, like, because I will have a mix of freshers and, you know, experienced guys, like guys who are working as manual test engineers. So the course duration would be 80 to 100 hours. Let me quickly show you like one of the tracker that, you know, that of my previous batches. Right. So this is one of my previous weekend batch. So you can see here, you know, like the total course duration came to 80 hours. So, of course, we missed to capture a couple of, you know, training hours here and there, right? As you can see here. So, but the total duration would be 80 to 100 hours. So, yeah. So, with this, I close this, you know, demo session. So, in the next demo session, you know, like I can show you, like, one sample script development with Loadrunner and JMeter 5.3. So Loadrunner Professional 2020 is the version that we are going to use for training going forward. And JMeter 5.3 is the latest version. So which we are going to, you know, do certification as well. Yeah, and one more thing. So, you know, JMeter certification is mandatory for every participant. So every participant has to do attempt JMeter certification, right? That is another important, you know, terms and conditions, right? So JMeter being open source tool, so it is fastly gaining the market share. So, you know, like we are targeting, you know, we want everyone in the batch to do JMeter certification. So thanks once again, thanks for your time. So please like, share, subscribe to my channel. So, you know, like, let me show you my channel. So if you go to Google, YouTube and, you know, search with performance testing real-time training. Here is my channel with this logo, right? As you can see here. Please like, share, subscribe to my channel. So we are going to, you know, start exclusive performance engineering training from 25th July, as well as we are starting Python training and Selenium training very soon. And DevOps, we already have one batch running for DevOps. All right. So, you know, please like, share, subscribe to my channel. Thanks everyone. Thanks for your time.